Hello, Michael McCarthy here, taking a look at another Ornatrix version 3 new feature. This is an exciting new feature that's going to allow us to actually model our hair with geometry using Ornatrix. If I go to the Create dropdown under Ephere Ornatrix, you can see that we have a new hair strips object. And this is going to allow us to create that object, go to the Modify panel, and then pick geometry strips in order to model our hair from. So if I click on Add, you can see that we get hairs in the viewport, and this is a real Ornatrix hair object, so I can go ahead and add any sort of Ornatrix modifiers to it, such as render settings or something else. You can see that we get that taper there with these render settings, so on and so forth. So we can adjust that with that geometry, but it's linked to this geometry and using it for its creation. So if I go in and I convert this to an editable poly, I can go into edge mode, and I can start doing things like extruding this out and having the hair follow along. So I can adjust that like so, and you can see that the hair gets created. I can do any sort of geometry manipulation that you might be used to doing in Max with Edit Poly or any of the modifiers. So I could add a Turbo Smooth to this. I could also use NURB Subdivision in order to smooth it out. And if I do that, I'm going to hop back, select our hair object, and just give it a few more subdivisions here in the points per strand. So we'll set that to 40 so that it's nice and smooth all the way through. Turn on show end results so that you can see the hair like so. Now in here we have a couple of different options. We can either use a per vertex hair creation, so all your vertices are going to create hair, a uniform hair creation, or a more random one, which is usually a little bit more natural. You can also set the amount of hairs that you have per strip and the amount that we see in the viewport. Let's take a look at a couple of strips that we set up with some of the parametric modeling tools here in Max. So I'm going to just unhide these strips. You can see that I've created a bunch of little hair strips here with some really simple parametric modeling in Max that we'd all be pretty familiar with. I'll just isolate this one for the moment, and you can see that we have, if we drop down, turn off show end result, you know, just kind of tapered the hair, bent it on a 90 degree angle, then bent it over again and use Turbo Smooth. So this is the nice thing about using the hair strips with Ornatrix, is you can use any of the modifiers, any of the modeling tools that you want to create your hair from. So I'm going to hop back out. Let's create another hair strips object. And you can see that you can pick multiple objects, as well as they don't have to be single strips like we have here, but for this situation it's kind of beneficial. So if I choose add multiple, I can add all these hair strips to that, and you can see it's generating hair. We'll make it a slightly different color. So there's all the hair getting generated. I'll go ahead and add my OX render settings so that we get the taper that goes down there. And I'm going to just turn off edge faces for the moment. You can see those, and we can hide these if we wish. Just so that we only see the hair in the scene. So here's all our hair getting created. We can go back down if we wish and set it to random. We can also adjust how many we see in the scene. So if we want to bump this up to 50% and go under render settings and make these a little bit smaller, you can see that we get some nice hair set up here. Now another great thing about this is that any of the edits that you do to the geometry are going to kind of propagate out. So if I select all these all this hair geometry and I apply something like a noise modifier, I can add a little bit of noise to this, set it to fractal, I'll bring that down. You can see that's going to affect the hairs as well, which is pretty interesting. If I just hide these guys, you can see how that's kind of deforming the hair. And of course you can add any of the Ornatrix modifiers again. So if I want to go and add some frizz to this, that might be a little bit too much. I can add any sort of frizz or something like that to it, or curling or things of that nature. But if I want more control over something like a curl, I can always model that. So let me just unhide this guy here. Here's a little hair strip that is pretty much the same as all the rest, except I've added this twist to it. And if I go back here, I can add that hair strip in, and you'll see that we'll get our hair that kind of twists along. Now another nice thing about this is any sort of animation you want to apply to the mesh, if you want to skin it, add some bones to it, or even just do basic modifier based animation, you can certainly do that, and that's going to propagate out to your hair. So if I have this twist strip selected and I decide that I want to untwist it at some point, I'll just set the amount to 0. And you can see that that is going to have our hair follow along with it. So this opens up a lot of cool possibilities with animation and really getting the correct hair targets that you might want to set up. So that's a little bit about the basics of how the tool works. Let's take a look at a little bit more complex scene with some hair strips that have already been set up. So I'm just going to open up a scene here. In this scene, we have a beautiful model of a woman provided by the guys over at Turbo Squid. They have a bunch of models like this, and if you go up there, you'll find there'll be a number of models with hair that's created in strips like this that you can generate your own real Ornatrix hair from. So you might already have some models like this where you've created the hair for games or for other productions. And if I just apply a basic material to this character, I'll just grab the hair there and apply that there, then you'll see that these are a bunch of strips that have been created for the character's hair. Now what we can do is we can just go over to create Ornatrix hair strips, and I'm gonna go in, click on add, and add our hair. You see the hair will get immediately added to the character, and I can add my OX render settings. So now you see that the hair is getting tapered from the actually the bottom to the top, which is one thing that we really want to look at here. Whenever you're setting this up and you do have a huge amount of planes like we do here, you're going to want to have some ability to rotate the direction of your hairs and things of that nature. So we have that here under the rotate dropdown, and there's a couple of different ways to do this quickly for all of your different hair objects. In this case, I can go down to choose flow down and just say rotate strip direction, and all of them kind of flow down in this direction, which is going to be pretty much the right setup. You can see that we do have some hair back here that is not actually going to need to flow down in that regard. So I can go into subobject strips, and let me just reduce the amount of hairs that we see. You can see that we have that there. I'll turn off show end result, and we can see that we have, I'm going to just hide the mesh object. You can see that we have arrows pointing for each one of these. So I'm going to go ahead and select this arrow that's pointing in the wrong direction, and I can just choose rotate, and I can rotate that on a per strip basis. So we want this pointing down in this direction, and then when we hop back out, turn on show end result, all of our hairs will be pointed in the right direction. So I'm going to choose random. Let's set this back up to about 50% so we can see all of our hair in there for the character. And you can see really quickly we get some nice hairs generated. We probably want to go into render settings and set this down to a 0.05 possibly, so that we have much thinner hair. And I'll just apply a material to that hair that'll give us some of the color that we're looking for with the character. I'm also going to go in and maybe smooth this out. You can see I only have a few points per strand, so I'll set that up to 30, which will get these to be nice and smooth on our character. I'll increase the amount of hairs per strip to maybe around 400, so we get many more hairs in here. Now, in this case, you can see that, especially on this side, you know, we're getting hairs all the way down here and they end right at the bottom, and that's going to be something that's very uniform. It does give us a good ability to use our strips to style our hairs in any way that we want, but what I can do is add things like our length modifier. So I'll go and click on length, and that's going to randomize the length, so I can increase or decrease that randomization. I'll set it to maybe 0.3, and you can see that that'll help us out there, and I'll add a little bit of frizz as well. So this will frizz the hair out a bit, maybe a little bit too much. Just go in here, I'll reduce the percentage of outliers and reduce the amount of frizz. We just want a little bit so that it kind of blends together some. And there we'll have styled our hair some. Now another nice thing about this is our hair is actually, the mesh portion has been skinned. So if I hide this, and I'll unhide that and bring this back, and I'll actually grab our bones. So I'm going to just display bones in the scene. You'll see that we have a few bones for the character, and there's a couple bones that have been skinned to the hair here. And that way we can actually animate and rotate our hair by hand, or we can use something like is on this with a spring controller. So if I take this and I just kind of press play, you'll see there's a little spring controller that's a little bit over exaggerated just for our demo purposes on the hair, and that's going to deform the hair that is created by this mesh. So if I go back in and I hide this and I'll bring back our hair. We'll just display this with a few less of these hairs, so I'm going to bring this down to maybe just 5%, and actually under render settings we'll make it a little bit larger so that it's pretty easy to see those hairs. And you can see that if we bring our hair object back, I'm just actually going to set this to display as a box, and you'll see that the hair is going to deform with that mesh. So whether if we want to do that, or if you want to kind of hand animate some of those bones, it's a nice way to kind of start animating your hair in the scene. And you know, you can do it with a few hairs like this so you get a really nice preview. And when you want to go back and set this back up to even 100% and bring your render settings back down to 0.05, you can let the viewport settle in so that you can see what kind of hair you'll end up getting rendered. I'll just go and hide our bone objects, and let's hide that hair object as well. So there's a quick introduction to the new hair strips object in Ornatrix version 3, which allow you to use your polygon modeling tools to model your hair and style it on your character, and also a quick introduction on how you might take an existing character that has hair strips and adopt that in order to create more realistic real Ornatrix hair that you can render out with 3ds Max, Base Renderer, Mental Ray, or V-Ray. I hope you enjoy this feature. Thank you very much.